When we think of our ancient ancestors, we often picture the Neanderthals. But who were these relatives of ours, and why do they matter? Today, we're diving into the world of the Neanderthals, the closest extinct human relative.
I've always been curious about them. What set them apart from us?
Great question, Olivia. Neanderthals were a distinct species called Homo Neanderthalensis. They were well adapted to cold climates, with a robust build and features that conserved heat.
So, they were like the ultimate winter survivalists?
Exactly. They had shorter limbs and stockier bodies than modern humans, which helped them survive in harsh environments. But that's just scratching the surface.
I'm intrigued.
They were also skilled hunters and toolmakers. Their tools were more sophisticated than those of earlier human species, showing a high level of intelligence.
I guess brains and brawn then, huh?
Precisely. Now, let's take a closer look at their culture and daily life. Neanderthals had a rich culture, evidenced by the artifacts they left behind. They made jewelry from shells and feathers, which suggests they had a sense of self and aesthetic appreciation.
That's fascinating. Did they create art as well?
There's evidence they did. Pigments and painting tools have been found at Neanderthal sites, indicating they may have painted their bodies or even cave walls.
So, they weren't just about survival. They had an artistic side too.
Indeed. And when it comes to daily life, they were primarily hunters and gatherers. They hunted large prey like mammoths and used sophisticated weapons like wooden spears.
Hunting mammoths? That's no small feat.
Absolutely. It required planning and teamwork, which shows they were capable of complex social behavior. Now, let's explore their social structure and how they might have interacted with each other. Neanderthals lived in small groups, likely made up of extended family members. This close-knit structure was crucial for their survival and allowed them to share knowledge and skills.
Did they have any kind of hierarchy or leaders?
It's hard to say for certain, but evidence suggests that they may have had leaders or elders who made decisions, especially during hunts or when facing threats.
I can imagine that would be important when taking down a mammoth.
Definitely. Their social interactions also included caring for the sick and elderly, which is evident from healed injuries found on their bones.
That's quite compassionate. It shows they weren't the brutish figures we often imagine.
Right. They were capable of empathy and complex emotional relationships. Now, let's delve into one of the most intriguing aspects, their interaction with early modern humans.
Oh, this is the part I've been waiting for.
The interaction between Neanderthals and early modern humans is a tale of both competition and cooperation. When modern humans arrived in Europe, they encountered Neanderthals who had been living there for thousands of years.
That must have been quite the meeting. Do we know what happened?
It's a bit of a mystery, but we do have clues. Genetic evidence shows that Neanderthals and modern humans interbred, which means there was certainly some level of cooperation and integration.
So, some of us have Neanderthal DNA?
Yes, many of us carry a small percentage of Neanderthal genes. But the interactions weren't always peaceful. There's also evidence of conflict and competition for resources.
I guess it's complicated, like most family reunions.
Indeed. Over time, Neanderthals began to disappear, and there are several theories as to why. Some suggest climate change, others disease, and some believe competition with modern humans played a role.
It's sad to think about their extinction.
It is, but their legacy lives on, not just in our DNA, but in the way they've shaped our understanding of human evolution. Now, let's wrap up with the lasting impact of Neanderthals on modern science and culture. As we come to the end of our journey, it's clear that Neanderthals have had a profound impact on both science and culture. Their existence challenges our notions of what it means to be human.
It's amazing to think that they still affect us today.
Indeed. The study of Neanderthals has revolutionized our understanding of human evolution, showing us that the path was not linear but a complex web of branches.
And with every new discovery, it seems like that web gets even more intricate.
Exactly. Our Neanderthal ancestors have also influenced culture, appearing in literature, art, and even debates about what makes us unique as a species.
They've become a symbol of resilience and adaptability.
That's right. And as we continue to uncover their secrets, we may find more ways in which they've shaped our past and continue to influence our future.
I can't wait to see what we'll discover next.
The story of the Neanderthals is far from over. It's a narrative that we're still piecing together, a puzzle that spans tens of thousands of years.
And we're lucky to be a part of it.
Absolutely. So, here's to the Neanderthals, our enigmatic relatives who continue to teach us about where we came from and perhaps where we're going.